Well, I was trying to decide between two stories to tell. One where happened actually, it's kind of like a nightmare, I guess. I felt an alligator was attacking me. But then I went with this one. Video game systems I've never owned or used, but I wish I did. I don't know how I'm going to word the title so it fits, but I will figure it out. That's what this is about. Some of these might be surprising you, some might not. But yeah, I'll explain a little bit about each one. I already did this, but it went on too long, 10 minutes, so. Yeah. The first one would be, this isn't in any particular order of any type, so. The first one would be the Vectrex. It's very unique. It was only released in the UK. Not many games released for it. It's pretty old. It's older than the NES, so that makes it a problem to get a hold of. I looked on eBay one time just out of the hell of it, just to see if any even appear. It goes for a lot of money, to say the least, about 300 and some. For what that costs, I can get the top of the line biggest hard drive PlayStation 3, so. Just by comparison. Or a working AES. Also by comparison. Or a very good game for the AES by comparison. Anyway, the real reason for this is because it's very unique compared to most other ones, other video game systems. It has its own built-in screen, yada yada yada. But it's the games themselves that make me want, or not so much the games, but the way the games look and act. That thing is from the 1970s. I can't remember which year exactly. But it works and runs so smooth, the games, like that one racing game. It's so smooth moving and looking. And I like the vector graphics, the wireframe stuff. It kind of reminds me of, well, it does remind me of the original Star Wars arcade, which is awesome too. That's about all there is to that. Next one would probably be the Atari 7800. This is probably the weirdest one on here I'm going to talk about. I've owned twice and used even before I even owned my own Atari 2600. That's from way before my time. The Atari 7800 is too, but it's closer to my time, yet I have never used it. I've never owned one, I've never used one, I've never even seen one in person. I've never seen a Vectrex in person either. I just don't know why. I really don't. I looked on the internet, I was actually going to get one time. They want too much money for what it is. Anyway, so I say that kind of stuff all the time. No, this one, they really do want way too much for what it is. There is no one screaming, pounding down the door for an Atari 7800. Controller sucks too. Never seen one in person either. I'm not even talking about for sale, just mean in person. Real reason for that is just because I like Atari. It could play 2600 games and it could also play its own. I've seen quite a lot of Atari 7800 games, but I never seen a 7800, so what the point would be me getting them if I can never use them? You know? So that's the deal with that one. Next one is, not all of these are game consoles, not handhelds either. It's like I said, systems, you know. Next one is the ZX Spectrum, like I said. This is technically a computer, but whatever. Specifically, the K plus 2, or whatever it's called. I've mentioned this before to many other people. I've never used one, never probably will. It's not available in this country, it never was. Although, I think it was under a different name, I don't know. It's from the 80s. It uses cassette tapes for the games. This is a, well, this is World of Worlds, but whatever. Takes like 10-20 minutes to load each game. I don't care. There is an emulator. I've tried using it, but it's absolutely atrocious. It's impossible to figure out. It's so weird working. Even when it does work, it doesn't work right. So I just gave up on it. It's worse than the Amiga emulator, and I gave up on that too. And I wanted that to work even more. But the real reason I like this thing other than the thing itself, what it looks like and its name. It's very well liked too, by the way, even to this day. There was a huge, really popular magazine for it. I can't remember what it's called. Crap. I used to know. Anyway, there's a lot of games for this thing. Kind of like how the Commodore 64 worked. But that's the reason I like it, is certain games I've seen on it, which is quite a bit, they appeal to me. The certain games on it. The Dizzy games. I've never played those. Though that's actually probably the top ones I would like to play on it, but, you know, I never get to. So. I have no idea what these even go for, if they're ever on eBay or anywhere else. I have no idea. I don't even know what they cost when they're brand new. Save out a lot of these. The next one is the Odyssey. I don't think I said that yet. This one, really, all it comes down to is it's the first game console. What blows about it is, and I think this is absolutely stupid even for when it came out, the only way you can play the games is if you have another player. That's absolutely stupid. And this is why I haven't done a WIS on this. What if they stop making single player games? Because it's absolutely fucking retarded. They're never going to do that because they can't get away with it. Back then or now, there is no one, not every single person has someone to play with. Or if they do, they don't want to do it. It's impossible. No one wants to play with someone every damn time, okay? So that was absolutely stupid of them to do back then. I could see why the first Odyssey didn't sell well, other than the fact that it was the first game console and what it cost and all that kind of stuff, and they weren't too sure about it, and there's only five things for it, and the thing comes with every game for it, but still, come on. It's absolutely absurd. The only way to play this shit is with someone else. Come on. Even the Pong game, you couldn't tell me that you couldn't make the friggin' thing fight against you with it? Come on. Yeah, so that's all there is to that. It's the first game console. Well, I wouldn't be able to play it because I got no one to play with, so whatever. Remember, this is owned or used, so one or the other or both, you know. Next after that would probably be the Atari ST. This one, I gotta admit, the whole reason I'm actually talking about this, not the alligator thing, is because I was talking to someone back replying to the comment thing, and it was something about the Atari ST, and I said I never used one. Well, I'd like to, I would ever. But this one, unlike some of these other ones, was actually released in the United States, but it did absolutely horrible. Kind of think of what the Master System, how it did over here, only worse. Master System did very good by comparison. It was huge in Europe, and it did shit over here. The thing itself is okay looking. It's just gray keyboard and yada yada yada. Again, the same thing I said about the ZX Spectrum, only more so. This one, I've seen a lot of games I would love to play on this. Quite a lot of racing games. There's a karate fighting game. I can't remember what it's called. I think it's called. I can't remember what it's called. I don't know. There's a lot of bad games on it too, like anything else. But you know, the Atari ST is probably one of the ones I would like to play a lot of things I've seen on it because they're not available on anything else. They never were afterward. So probably the only other one, which is probably be the most easiest one to do out of all these, other than the Atari 7800, is because it's available in this country, is the ColecoVision. I've never actually used one. Used an Intellivision. I used one for about 2 months straight. It wasn't mine. So I've got a lot of time in with the Intellivision. I like it a lot. The first one, not the white one. You know, the brownish black one with the gold buttons. That one I've used. The ColecoVision never used. I don't know why. I think I had a chance to, but I didn't get to. I had a chance to, but I didn't get to at the same time. I don't know, it's kind of hard to explain. I'm aware of the thing that lets you play Atari 2600 games on it. That's not why I want to play its own games, because it has games on it that are the equivalent of Atari 2600 games, only they look better, but they don't run as smooth, so they sacrificed gameplay for working. And I have a feeling I'm about to be interrupted, so I gotta end this, but yeah, I just wanted to use that, so that's all. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Do you have any that, like, for you wish you would have owned or used or got just to use? I'll see you next time.